Welcome back, Hordlings, to more Might and Magic 2 for the Fanicom. Hopefully you didn't think I was going to abandon this project. Not going to happen. However, I did want to get the original that we started for the Genesis completed and done with. And even start 3, which we've done. I've been focusing a lot on Bard's Tale, the remaster, obviously. But when I can, I'm going to upload some of this and some Might and Magic 3 to go alongside it. This particular game, though, is more of a side project, if you will. It does not get priority. I took it upon myself to do this. However, Stinky Weasel Teats donated for the actual Might and Magic 2, 3, 4, and 5. So, those will need to be priority. Even though I haven't heard from Stinky, I don't know where he went. He fucking disappeared off the face of the earth. I still have an obligation to complete these games for him. How the hell? There we go. Crusader and Diplomat. Magic Cat! Sprites are dying left and right! Fairy wings flutter all around us as the bodies fall. It also smells like burnt kitty. Chest here. Short bow plus 2. Well, we know that area is all monsters and fighting. Let's actually go check out B2. Something gleams underneath the snow. Alright, the Icicle plus 2 from the original game is also here. Oh, never mind, that's Caster. Was the Battle Axe plus 4 on Ronstock. I don't think Caster will be able to use it either. Oh well, we can sell it. Boo! Definitely need to get rid of these hypno bugs. Backstab! Try Turn Undead again. Okay, skeletons are immune to my Turn Undead for some reason. Some dead goblins. We take their sack. Sarakin Mines. Well, there's some woods we can travel through, apparently. Interesting. Let's go see if that spider is here. There's a death spider. Oh man, that hurts. Christ. Oh man. Better make use of power cure. Enemy HP restored. Thank you. Death Spider unaffected. Ah, thank God. Those dudes hit hard, man. I need to retreat back to town and heal and save after this. Jesus. That's an awesome reward. So I don't think the actual talking spider is there, because we went on his space. Let's retreat. Some solid water. And we'll save. Need to get my spell points back. Orc beer. I love an orc beer. Great sake. Some ghoul soup. And have a tip. Just the tip. Ah, see, they're letting me move through forest. Some forest you can go through and some you can't. I love this paralyzed shit. Son of a bitch. Holy shit, this is annoying. Well, don't get paralyzed. That sucks. Okay. Let's try not to get killed by death spiders. I'm really perturbed at the fact that the auto map will keep where I've been on in towns, but not dungeons in the overworld. Makes me want to continue searching the towns. Check out Volcania. Kron must be saved! Four lords hold four talons. Four lords and four domains. Water, fire, earth, wind. Well, if you've watched my other LP, you know that the end of the game very much involved with the four elemental planes. Trained to be a gladiator. Crackhack has no skills. We can make him a gladiator. Why not? Doesn't seem to be anything else. I believe that gives him more hit points. This will probably be a fight because it's a key. Oh no, this is the tent guy. Sergeant Payne will make Ronstock a soldier. We have an arms master as well. I think they help with accuracy. I The icicle! Hang on to that for now. There's a lot of fighting in this town. And not sure how difficult the enemies here are, so let's a random encounter. We like random jugglers. Night-night, jugglers! Fire arrow and guard dog. Guard dog keeps you protected while you sleep so you don't get surprised. And that is the person that lets you forget skills. I'm having a hard enough time fucking finding them. Some pretty basic enemies. Looks like they kept all the town enemies pretty much the same. They didn't make them get crazy hard like they did in the Genesis, the original PC version. meant to cast undead, turn undead, but as we saw earlier, it does not always work. This is just going to be all enemies, as it is in the normal game. And it looks like there's a magic dead zone here as well. Do a quick save as to not lose any of what we have done. Danger! Oh, we know the giant scorpions can be dangerous. Vampire rat! Just here! In the original game, that chest actually says, look, someone stashed a lava grenade in this corner and now it's yours. I don't remember actually getting... Oh, there's the lava grenade. Cool. So that hasn't really changed, which is cool. Thank you. made that cocoon my bitch! These are all enemies behind here. I didn't really want to spend the whole video fighting typical enemies in a dungeon or in a town. So pretty much all those brown areas are going to be more fights. Come back here and squash that at a different time. That's not going to help us progress the game, which is where I am leaning towards right now as we are kicking everything's ass in this town. And I seem to recall the same was pretty much going on in Atlantean as well. Yeah, so we got pretty much got Atlantium uncovered, besides all the fighting areas as well on this. Caster needs a lot less than us for some in the rest of the party. Pain! Pain! I'll show you Gnome Elder's pain. Murray knows about three swords. I remember those three swords. No, I had to come check on that fountain again. Get some magic pussy! So yeah, it looks like it's letting me travel through the forest that I'm allowed to travel through. That'll definitely make things more difficult. I got the money. Fuck, get the long dagger plus five. Regular scale armor, great shield. Meh. However, who has a helmet and who doesn't? Great helm. Looks like I gave it to all of them. Iron helm. Specials suck. We don't want to go to the catacombs. Guess I'm going back home to Middlegate. Fucked up by Goblin and Pegasi. Thank you. All right. Let's head outside, try to get into some trouble. Ninjas. Fireball them ninjas. Okay, we don't want to get put to sleep, so we need to take that bug out. Monstock got KO'd and lost a level from a ninja. I hope that's not permanent. This spot was actually supposed to have a guy that taught us the walk on water spell, which I was hoping to get. Alright, still level 7. Castor is finally getting closer to 7. Stone to flesh, cure wounds. Are a lot different, but obviously there is the maps are identical. There's a lot of differences between them. And without pathfinding and the mountaineering skill and just being able to walk over trees and mountains, it makes getting to certain things that were easier in the other game a lot harder in this game. For instance, if I'm trying to go fight the Black Knight for the Knight Quest, you have to be able to pass through mountains and forest or be able to walk on water to get to them, as far as I know. Go check out the Druid's cave just to check something out? Why not? See how fast we get our ass kicked down here. Really disappointed there's not some kind of cartography spell or skill to keep these permanently mapped, especially when you can do so in the town. If anyone knows anything about this, chime in. Let me know in the comments. All right. I think the strength buff is here. I don't know. Let me double check. Should be it. Let's definitely cast some levitation. There's lots of snare traps here. Let's see, we have our little wing down there. They're cave-ins, apparently. Okay, these are not terrifying monsters in the least bit. Chest here. And a bunch of common shit as well. Rattlesnake and a swamp dog. The swamp dogs are no more. So the strength buff is up here. It's in this little corner, however, I probably teleported in there in the normal game. Oh, there we go, there's actually a wall. Boo! These killer cadavers will explode. So it's good to kill them first. Nice graphic. Can of spinach, sheet up. I want to see all our stats first. '20 and '23. The two people I give a shit about. Okay, plus 10 might to the party. The question is can we spam this like we could in the other game? for a certain amount of time. So obviously we're gonna try, right? We can see now that Ronstock has 30 might and Kragak has 33, so that's good. This is a start to start getting the party powerful. And the fights are not that bad to get there, so I am going to definitely continue to level up our might. Got Nature's Gate, time, something. No teleport and no etherealization, obviously, yet. Acid Blob and a Druid. Same battle. Oh, and shit, we're still silenced. Yeah, that sucks. And diseased. Not sure if silence will fall off from arrest. Obviously, that's going to prevent me from being able to cast remove condition or levitate anymore. And it's gone. It's a one-time thing. It's also too dangerous to rest, apparently. Okay, well, I'll take my plus 10 strength for sure. I had a feeling they took out the ability to wash, rinse, and repeat that. I probably wouldn't let you do that if I made the game, or I'd at least put it in different places. So I'm gonna go ahead and get out of here and pile ass back in town. We're about to close the video. But hey, got something done. Get a little heal on at the temple. Feeling groovy. Well, that wraps it up for this episode of Might and Magic 2 for the Super Famicom. Famicom and the Japanese translation over onto English. Very cool game, very cool translation. If you haven't checked it out, you can download it off of Emu Paradise, I believe, or some shit, ROM hacking. I'm pretty sure I put the description in the link in the very first video. If not, I will make sure I do so at some point. Anyways, thanks for watching, and if you have any tips or tricks or good directions on where to go or any ideas if there's a cartography skill or anything else that's different than the Genesis version that I just completed, leave it in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you.